Welcome into the Jones Center in Springdale, Arkansas, as we get set to bring you a special broadcast here on the Razorbacks channel as we bring you the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs varsity high school team as they take on the Kansas City Stars. My name is Corry Porter. Alongside me, EJ Sanders, Rich Sanders. As always, happy to have you here, guys. And, you know, last weekend we got a chance to see the Bantam teams play here in Northwest Arkansas, and today we get to see the high school team on a very special senior night, as we'll do the presentation of that, and then we'll bring you the game starting at about 3:15.
The Flats family has generously donated to the new workstation desks that are now being installed in the hallway in honor of Carl. These desks not only enhance the facility, but also serve as a lasting tribute to a man who embodied the spirit of hockey and community. The gift from the Flats family ensures that current and future hockey enthusiasts will have the opportunity to live, work, and play in a space that carries the indelible mark of Carl's work. In recognition of this profound gesture, let's join together in a round of applause to express our deep appreciation to the Flats family for this generous and meaningful contribution. And now we honor the senior class of 2024. First up is James Young.
And the first senior announced is James Young.
This is James' 8th year in hockey, playing 3 years in Tulsa, 1 year in Oklahoma City, and his 4th year in Arkansas. James attends Epic Charter School. James's plans after high school is he has applied and been accepted to Lake Superior State University in Michigan. He will be majoring in fire science with a minor in EMT technology. He hopes to continue playing hockey and will be trying out for the LSSU ACHA team in the fall. His favorite hockey memory is playing in nationals and winning the first ever game in organizational history. James would like to thank his coaches, Derek and Jerry, for teaching him how to be a better defenseman, Tommy for being an edge work master, Matt and Seth for believing in him, and Mike for giving him an opportunity to play. He would like to thank his teammates. Without everyone putting in the effort, none of this would be possible. And finally, he gives thanks to his parents, to his mom for driving hundreds of miles to and from practice and giving up hours upon hours sitting at the rink. And a thank you to his dad for turning a blind eye every time he broke a stick or needed new skates. James says he'd like to close this with hard work meets talent when talent doesn't work hard. Don't let other people dictate to you what you can or can't do in life. If you want something, work for it, and go and get it. Once again, number 9, James Young.
Again, that's number 9, James Young. He's played in 16 games this season. 0 goals, just 1 assist. But, you know, on senior night here, they're going to try to help their teammate out and get him one.
After high school, we'll be moving to Michigan at the end of the senior year to attend college and continue playing hockey. Devin lists his favorite...
Next up, number 33, Devin Dixon. Also played in 16 games this year. 1 goal, 1 assist, 2 points. And an excellent flow, if I do say so myself. Good head of hair on the kid.
Coach Maddie for always seeing the potential and having trust in him as a player. And Coach Mike for seeing the value, even in the hardest work. He says, I would like to thank you for always finding a way to let me know that I am always fighting for. Devin also thanks our team photographers and videographers, Liz, Stephen, and Lance. The work you did provided me with amazing pictures and perfect videos allowed me to be a better player. He would would like to thank all of his supporters for taking the time to come and support him at the games. And he says, next, I want to thank my family, David, my little brother, just for being here. Natalie, my sister-in-law, for always reminding me I got my better. Dylan, my oldest brother, for always being second best. Dad, for making the countless hours of reviewing data for me and finding the things to make me better. Always being willing to pay all of his dollars for my dreams. And my mom, for the many hours on the road, the unconditional love, and those mad dance moves. Last but certainly not least, is God. Thank you, God, for waking me up every day, keeping me healthy and safe all year, and providing me with the opportunity to play the greatest sport in the world. Soccer will never compare now to the world. And leaving on the high note, hey fans, what do a bad hockey player and the Titanic have in common? They both look good until they hit the ice. Thank you all for an amazing senior year. Number 33, Devin Dixon.
Once again, number 33, Devin Dixon. I think we got about 10 seniors on this team.
Next up, number 15, Tevin O'Dell, playing wing.
And next, number 15, Tevin O'Dell. 16 games played. He's got 2 goals, 5 assists for 7 points on the season. A couple penalty minutes to go along with it. As he makes his way to meet his family at center ice.
And he would like to thank his parents, coaches, and the hockey community for their support and love. He says, I am grateful for the memories and experiences that you shared. Number 15, Tevin O'Dell. Next up, number 77, Tyler Wall.
And next is number 77, Tyler Wall. Appeared in 14 games this year. Still looking for that first point.
He says, I would like to thank my mom and dad for being awesome taxi drivers and my coaches, especially Coach Deere from Oklahoma City, for pushing me and putting me up. Number 77, Tyler Wall.
Once again, number 77, Tyler Wall.
Next up, Renuk Atuba. Number 44, Tony Ford. Renuk has played 2 years at the time and currently attends.
And number 44, Renuk Atuba.
Renuk spends after high school.
Looks like he's only appeared in 1 game so far for the Ice Hogs.
In the fall, Renuk will be attending the University of Central Florida to study aerospace engineering. His favorite hockey memory is making his first goal with the Ice Hogs to Cable Dollar Arena against the Kansas City Knights during their preseason game. Renuk says he would like to thank Coach Selvin, Coach Madden, and all the players in the clinics for their support and encouragement. Number 44, Renuk Atuba.
Again, number 44, Renuk Atuba.
Number 88, Keegan Fitzgibbons.
And next up is number 88, Keegan Fitzgibbons. 15 games played, 6 goals, 3 assists for 9 points. And I think we may be having some issues with the video. We're working to get that fixed before the game starts, but just wanted to let you all know.
Keegan would like to thank his mom, dad, and everyone in his family. He says, thank you for all the time and miles you have invested in me over the years. I can't thank you enough for everything that you have done. Ladies and gentlemen, number 88, Keegan Fitzgibbons. Number 19, Harper Romanson.
And next up, yeah, number 19, Harper Romanic. He's appeared in 16 games this season. 6 goals, 7 assists for 13 points, including 1 power play goal and 30 penalty minutes.
Harper says he would like to thank his mom and dad for supporting him in his hockey career, from taking me to games far away or just to practice, and raising me to be my full potential. Graham, Nan, Papa, love you guys. Joe Shu, Fred DeFault, Coach Manning, Coach Gray, Coach Sean and Don, Coach Shipselling, Coach Jeremiah Graham, Coach Vince Brick, for pushing me to be my best on and off the ice during my time at the mall. Ladies and gentlemen, number 19, Harper Romanic.
Again, that's number 19, Harper Romanic.
Assistant captain, number 23, Jackson Simmons.
Next up, number 23, the assistant captain, Jackson Semmingsen. 16 games played, 8 goals, 2 assists for 10 points, and 28 penalty minutes.
Jackson currently attends Harper High School, and after graduation, he plans to attend the University of Arkansas with a double major in business and broadcasting. Jackson says, "My favorite hockey memory was playing the national in my sophomore year. That year, our team truly felt like family. We played as a team because we were both connected and had the utmost respect for each other, both on and off the ice. Thank you to everyone who has contributed to my career, but especially thank you to my parents for taking me to practice, along with trips to our games every weekend, and texting me heartfelt messages before games, showing me how much they loved me. I am forever grateful to this team and coaches, as well as past teammates, for making me a player that I am today." Ladies and gentlemen, number 23, Jackson Semmingsen. Again, number 23, Jackson
Semmingsen.
Assistant captain, number 24, Wyatt Flocks.
And number 24, Wyatt Flocks. The other assistant captain on this team has appeared in 16 games, 10 goals, 7 assists, for 17 points, including 2 power play goals and 6 penalty minutes.
After graduation, Wyatt plans to go to college for aeronautics and aviation science, or maybe just for a while. Wyatt says his favorite hockey memory is spending weekends at the hotel with the team. In Wyatt's words, "I would like to thank all of my coaches from Tulsa and here at Arkansas for helping me progress in the sport I love. I'd like to thank my grandparents for all the support through the highs and lows of my life, and my grandmother for all the late nights spent in the car, going to and from practices and games my first 3 years playing here on this team. Granddad brought me to all my practices, and I learned a lot of valuable lessons during those car rides. But unfortunately, he is no longer with us anymore. Rest in peace, man. Love you. And last, but certainly not least, I am thankful to my parents for helping me with anything and pushing me to do the best I can with everything and anything I do. And with all that said, I would like to say thank you to all of you and greatly appreciate everything." Ladies and gentlemen, number 24, Wyatt Flocks.
Again, that's number 24, Wyatt Flocks.
And your captain, number 79, Cooper Helsing.
And the captain, number 79, Cooper Helsing. 14 games played, 5 goals, 7 assists for 12 points, including 6 penalty minutes.
After graduation, Cooper looks forward to moving to Florida to enjoy the sun, sand, and waves while pursuing a trade from his certification. Cooper says his favorite hockey memory is winning the Blue Note Cup in St. Louis. Cooper says he would like to thank his mom and dad for all of their support and miles driven back and forth all over the race. He would like to thank his sister Riley for always being his biggest and loudest cheerleader in the stands and in life. He would also like to thank his little brother Chris for pushing him to be the best role model he could be. Cooper would like to thank all of his coaches for supporting him and teaching him everything I know about life. Ladies and gentlemen, number 79, Cooper Helsing.
Once again, that's number 79, the captain, Cooper Helsing.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give one more round of applause for our 10 seniors.
And that'll do it for the presentation of the 10 seniors here for the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs varsity team. Good job honoring those seniors here today at senior night. Once again, the Ice Hogs are going to be taking on the Kansas City Stars starting in about 12 minutes, give or take, as they clean up the senior paraphernalia, as we see some pretty cool posters of the seniors there as well. So good job honoring the seniors once again. You know, I was here this morning playing with the 8U kids and just seeing the growth of hockey in this area. I think we talked about it a bit last week, and it's good to see the game continuing to grow. And, you know, I'm glad to see teams like Kansas City and teams from St. Louis last week coming into Arkansas and playing some hockey here in the South. All right. Once again, our broadcast team today, my name is Corry Porter, running camera for us today, EJ Sanders and Rich Sanders by my side. Happy to have you here. Looking forward to watching some high school hockey?
Absolutely. Got two pretty well-matched teams. The Ice Hogs are 10-4-1. Kansas City Stars are 8-6-2. Just watching the observation I had from the kids coming out, it's a great time for moms and dads. They should be honored too for all the, I mean, it's a lot more work than any other sport I can think of. I mean, maybe swimmers got to get up at 4 a.m., but hockey, it's the travel, it's the amount of money that gets poured into the program, into the equipment, into the travel, and they all ought to be lauded. They've done a great job just to get here, and I'll be excited to see what they can do on the ice.
Yeah, absolutely. Looking forward to see what kind of talent this high school team has. Game starting in about 5 minutes. They're going to put on the clock for a warm-up. And then coming up after that, we have the JV team as well taking on the JV KC Stars team. So stick around for that game as well. But looking forward to this high school matchup here on a rainy day in Arkansas. A little chilly.
Beautiful day for hockey.
Sure. Great day to be inside.
Now, one of the things I noticed about the senior lineup is that five of them are among the top 10 in scoring, and that's probably the perfect balance. You've got five guys who you know, you're going to miss them next year, but you've got five more in the awnings that are going to come out here and probably do more of the same, keep the program growing. It started from nothing. You know, there wasn't a Jones Center at one time, and before that, I don't know what we did. I can't remember what we did for fun. It wasn't hockey, though.
I remember going to one roller hockey practice at Great Day Skate Place in Bentonville when I was about five or six before I moved to New York and started playing ice hockey up there. But, yeah, that might have been the only options back then. But as we heard the seniors going through and announcing and thanking their families and everybody, you know, I just noticed all the kids that have years and years of experience, and a couple of them having to travel, you know, going to play in Tulsa a couple years, going to play junior somewhere else before ultimately coming back here in Arkansas. And I'm glad they have a place to come back home to and a sheet of ice that they can go home and, you know, play some hockey here in Arkansas.
I'd like to see. I don't know what the makeup is of the players themselves. Are they all Fable High, Springdale High, Harbor students? I'm sure we must get some from Rogers and Bentonville. I'd kind of like one of those old being a spoiled sports writer from years ago, where you had the guy's name and his hometown. I always liked, yeah. And I always thought, you know, like, and I'll go ahead and say it, Shiloh Christian should have the hometowns listed for the players.
Sure.
Whereas, you know, when you went to a game at Fayetteville, everybody was in Fayetteville. Here, I think it's we've probably got a good mix of players from several different communities around the area.
Yeah, I would think so. And, you know, it's nice to get enough kids to get a team together, but maybe one day in the future we have a Rogers team, we have a Fayetteville team or Springdale team, something like that, to where we can play these high-level local games without having to travel every weekend, you know, making our way to St. Louis or wherever it may be.
Can't say enough about the Jones Center and what it's done. I mean, we do make fun of it, and we do it in a loving way, kind of like I do with, say, my son or something.
Sure.
You love it. You want to always have it and cherish it. But we've heard rumblings in the rumor mill of a possibility of a new and bigger rink, enlarging a rink, whatever it is they do. Though at the Jones Center, what they've done so far has been tremendous for this community. You know, because we had nothing. It's not even cold enough to have a pond in your backyard. So to have the Jones Center here available to people that just ice skate, if they want to learn how to curl, I think EJ's been out, gave that a shot one day. So we're all up for all the games that they can come up with to play here on the ice rink. Broom ball, maybe?
A little broom ball action out there, I think.
There you go.
Yep. All right, I think we're going to take a short break, try to get some of our camera issues worked out, and then we'll be back for the call of the game here in about 5 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back into the Jones Center in Springdale, Arkansas, as the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs get set to take on the Kansas City Stars. My name is Corry Porter. Alongside me, Rich Sanders, EJ Sanders. Getting ready for puck drop. About 35 seconds left in this warm-up before we finally get to see this high school team play here on senior night.
Yeah, super excited to see these two teams play. A special thank you again to Coach Keller Sims of the University of Arkansas and the Arkansas Razorbacks for allowing us to use the broadcast to showcase some teams in the area. We had the opportunity to showcase some Bantam teams last weekend, and today we're going to be doing the high school kids. It is senior night for these kids out here on the ice, so they're excited to get going. Quite a few seniors on this team, 10 of them to be exact. If you are looking for the Arkansas Razorbacks game, that'll be on 6 p.m. Central Standard Time, and that'll be over on Web Sports Radio, so you can tune in to the Arkansas-Missouri State game, game two of a two-game set there. They lost yesterday, Arkansas did, 6-3 to Missouri State, making a comeback in the third period after being down 5-0 after two. So that's the update on the Razorbacks. This is a younger team. Like we said, they're called the Ice Hogs in the area here, as they don't use the Razorbacks trademark or anything like that. But we're really excited to see some high school hockey this weekend.
Yep. And as far as goaltenders for the Ice Hogs, it looks like Ben McMaster is going to get the start, number 35. He's played in 15 games this year, 9-4-1 record with a 9-10 save percentage and a 2.11 goals against average. And on the other side, it's going to be William Aiden Carrasco Cooper. I hope I got those names right in the right order, but he's also seen game action in 16 games this year. Record of 8-6-2, goals against average 2.25, and a 920 save percentage. Looks like we will get a starting lineup announcement. And we'll have 15 minutes on the clock. These teams look ready to go.
Thank you guys for doing this. I appreciate
it. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to today's varsity matchup between the Kansas City Stars and your Northwest Arkansas High School.
Good crowd on hand for the high school game.
On defense, number 77, John Regas.
And John Regas.
Number 10, Preston Harris.
And Preston Harris starting on defense for the Stars.
Number 97, Luke Gressel. At forward, number 14, Austin Evans.
The forwards. And Nick Woolington rounding out the starters. And once again, William Aiden Carrasco Cooper in goal for the Stars.
And now, the starting lineups for your Northwest Arkansas High School. On defense, number 9, James Young.
And on defense, it's going to be the senior James Young getting the start, along with Wyatt Flox, fellow senior.
Number 19, Harper Rumancic.
Cooper Helsing. And Jackson Semmingson rounding out the starting lineup for the Ice Hogs. And again, Ben McMaster in goal for the home team. And we'll go ahead and pause for the national anthem. Yeah, 15 minutes on the clock, a packed crowd, a couple triangles and cowbells in the audience as well. I think we're going to have a good one here today.
Well, it's really awesome to see how these fans here have turned out yet again. Two weekends in a row, the Bantams had a pretty good crowd last weekend, but this is a comparable crowd to what we've seen at Arkansas games. If you were to look at them about 5 or 6 years ago, this would be a pretty packed house, or what we would have called that. Nowadays, they're shoving 1,000 people in this building.
Yep. Yeah, but definitely all the seats up here packed shoulder to shoulder, and you know, family and friends all came out to see their seniors play and to see these rare home games for these Ice Hogs who typically travel quite a long ways to play their hockey. But get a home game here on senior night. Looks like we are set for puck drop. At center ice, it's going to be Semigson in there to take the draw against Wollington. It's going to be won by the Stars, but picked up by Phlox for the Ice Hogs. He's going to take it back into his own zone. Had some trouble with the referee, taken away, trying to center it up. Wollington lost his stick. He's going to have to pick it up. It's going to be brought up the near side now as the Ice Hogs look to break out. Battle for it on the near side boards. They do get it. Helsing's chasing it down. He's got one man to beat. As we get some bumping on the near side boards, and the Stars are going to come away with it. 3-on-2, coming back the other way across the blue line. Harris, centering pass, broken up in front. Bounding puck came towards the net, but ultimately picked up by Helsing, and he's going to come the other way with it once again up the right wing. Left-handed stick. He's going to go to the backhand. Turnaround pass. Tried to center it up, but a good defensive play in front to break that one up. And just flipping it into the zone is Austin Evans as McMaster makes his first save, and the Stars go for a change. Helsing, outlet pass, chipped into the zone. And chased down there. Picked up now by Sanders. Battle for it in the corner. Stars are going to come away with it. Bring it to the near side now. Having a tough time getting it to the blue line. Arkansas giving them all kinds of fits as they tie it up in the corner. Good spacing here. That one comes out to the center. It's going to be carried in now by Harrington. Harrington forced wide, but comes in. Pass. Puck still loose in front. Finally taken away by Sanders. As I think McMaster had to make a couple saves in there. That puck was just loose, sitting on the doorstep. But Sanders controls it now for the Ice Hogs. He's going to turn back. 13:15 to go here in the first period. Outlet pass to the near side. Going to be shoveled ahead by Bartlett. Now Freed finds a man far side, Sullivan. Sullivan makes a move, takes a shot, and a save by Carrasco Cooper. First action he's seen today. And he holds on to the puck for no whistle. 13:01 here in the first period. Kansas City Stars with early pressure, couple shots, but the Ice Hogs with a more recent shot. And it looks like an offensive zone faceoff to the right of Carrasco Cooper. Like Freed is going to be there at center to take the draw for the Hogs. And it looks like we're actually going to have a penalty as
Tristan Pryor
is going to go to the box. A 5-on-4 man advantage for the Ice Hogs as they win the draw back to Sanders. Circles at the blue line, keeps it in. Patient with it. Back centering pass, broken up nicely. Sanders with it once again. Sanders having to fight a man off. Thought about the wraparound, but instead he's going to go back to the point. Sullivan takes the shot, gets through the traffic. Save. Rebound was there. Cleared to the sideboards. Carrasco Cooper with another save, and this one's sent all the way down the ice. And a minute 30 remaining on the penalty for the Stars. As the Ice Hogs look to break out, nearly turn it over at their blue line. And it's going to be Sanders for the Ice Hawks. Stars in the middle of a change. Lot of room as Phlox has it up the right side. Makes a move around a man. Centering pass through the traffic into the far side board. Sanders at the blue line. Wheels it around. And it's taken away. Flipped off the boards and nearly out of play by Wollington. Finally picked up. And this one is going to be just offsides, as Hawking couldn't find it in his skates, and Austin Evans came behind the play, picked up the puck, got a nice quick shot away, but just offside on the play. And no shot registered. 56 seconds remaining on the power play for the Hogs. Semmingson in to take the draw against Woolington. And the Hogs control it. Outlet pass goes errant, but finally picked up by Romantic. He does get it into the zone, but not before it's sent down the ice once again. 11:42 remaining in the first. 40 seconds on the power play. The Hogs with a man advantage trying to break out of their own zone. And they finally do get it out. Semmingson with a head of steam across the blue line. He's going to play one back. Holding it there. Shot goes wide of the net into the near side corner now. Back to the point. Can handle it. And chasing it down is Mulligan. He's got Evans in his back pocket. But Mulligan with a nice move and an outlet pass to Helsing. Couldn't handle it. And it's going to be chipped in the zone once again with just 10 seconds remaining on that penalty. The Stars have to put up with one more rush from Fitzgibbons as he gets it in, shoots it high of the net. And we're back to 5-on-5 action, kept in the zone by Sullivan. He's going to kick it in deep. It's going to be picked up by Harris. He plays it up the near side boards, but the Hogs, again, giving him fits, breaking out of their zone. Centering pass, nobody home on that one. It's going to come all the way down the ice, and the Hogs will have to chase it. It's Romantic on the puck, having to make a move around a man. It's being pressured hard by Pryor. Centering pass, broken up nicely. Good play by the Stars, but the defense from the Ice Hogs holds strong. Pryor to Harris, sends it back below the goal line. Brace now. It's got Odell on him, and Romantic. Romantic having trouble with it. Picked up by Mulligan. Has it poked away from him, but Odell picks it up as the Ice Hogs go for a change. Nifty move all by himself, and he takes a nice bump at center ice. Good hit there by Pryor. And the Ice Hogs do get a full change, but not before the Stars get possession of the puck. Skating out of the zone now. All alone. Shot goes wide. And a battle for it now on the near side boards. 9:45 remaining here in the first. 0-0 game between the Ice Hogs and the Kansas City Stars. Brennan picks it up for the Stars. Got tripped up, but no call, and coming back the other way with it. Takes a quick shot, glove save. And it comes to the near side boards. That was Dixon on the shot. That's another huge hit late on. As Young took a bump. Puck still loose in the corner. Comes back out. Sullivan able to keep it in nicely. As Young tries to chip it in. Sullivan again at the blue line. Just chips it into the corner. Battle for it there. Nice outlet pass. Finds the stick of his man. Across the blue line. This is Paulson. Paulson centering pass. Broken up. Shoots and he scores. Plamondon looked to bury that one. And just like that, it's 1-0 Stars. If we could take a look at the replay. Yeah, just breaking into the zone, throws it at the net, and unfortunately for the Hogs, just kind of got tied up in the skates. And just sitting on the doorstep was Plamondon to pick it up. And the Stars lead 1-0, and Plamondon gets his second of the season.
Tough break for the Ice Hogs there, and they find themselves down 1-0 on senior night.
Bartlett to Sanders. Sanders, nice outlet pass, 2-on-2 the other way, but ahead of steam, makes it a 2-on-1. Takes a quick shot and misses the net, or Carrasco Cooper might have got a piece of that. Send it to the near side boards. And it's coming back the other way. Once again, Plamondon dumps it in, and the Stars are going to get a change. 8:30 to play. Ice Hogs trying to break out of their own zone. Mulligan to Fitzgibbons. He'll send it far side and into the zone, making a move. That's Sanders. Sanders finds a man. Tried a one-timer, but couldn't quite get enough on it. That was Freed on the chance and coming back the other way now. This is Gressel with the puck. It's forced wide nicely. I think that was Semmingson getting in there. Puck now on the near side boards. Bounces out. Harris with a quick shot and a good save by McMaster. Rebound comes to the near side. Holding it there. Gressel steps up in front. Tries to pick a corner. Good save there by McMaster. And coming back the other way, Fitzgibbons. He's got Sanders with him. Fitzgibbons plays it ahead. Good job breaking it up by the Stars. And the Ice Hogs have to regroup. Sullivan plays it to Sanders, being pressured by Brace. And he gets it to Semingsen. Had trouble in the skates. It's going to be Brace once again picking it up, but he was all alone. And Sullivan able to flip it up in the air, but glove down nicely before the Hogs break out. Romancic is going to dump it in the zone, chase it himself. And the outlet pass here from Brace. Broken up at center ice by the Hogs. Romancic couldn't pick it up. And once again, Brace sends it in the zone. A high stick from Helsing. Touched up by the Stars first. And now that's Pittman with it for the Ice Hogs. He'll wheel it to the near side. Helsing trying to chip it out. Comes out in front of the Arkansas net before Helsing tries to split three men, but a good job closing the door on that by the Stars defense. And again, Arkansas as Romancic sends it. Now Semingsen. Semingsen tries to pick a corner. Cooper Carrasco threw a blocker up at it. Not sure if he got a piece or not, but Arkansas finding everything but the back of the net at this point. Romancic with it in the corner. Takes his time, but it's going to be taken away nicely. That was Persbilski. You can check me on that name in the comments if you don't mind. Battle for it at center ice. Far side, Brennan. Chasing it down with Pittman. Plays it the near side. Just out of the reach of Romancic. And Romancic finally does get it back. We're going to get a whistle here. And I think Arkansas is going to go to the box once again. Semingsen got tied up behind the play with Pryor. And Semingsen's going to take a couple minutes off. Stars are 0 for 1 on the power play so far. They do lead in this game 1 for nothing.
I believe it was Northwest Arkansas that had the power play early.
You are correct. This will be the first power play for the Stars. The first kill attempt for the Ice Hogs. It's going to be Plamondon in there to take it. Against Phlox, back to McNally. McNally takes a shot, save, and covered up nicely by McMaster. Good face-off win by the Stars. Able to get a quick shot, but not a lot of traffic in front. McMaster able to jump right on top of that rebound. Just 5 seconds gone on the minor. Once again, Phlox and Plamondon. Plamondon wins it again. Back to McNally. Takes his time. As Bartlett makes a nice play to clear the zone for the Ice Hogs. And the Stars have to regroup. They'll dump it to the corner, chase it down now. Awkward bounce, comes out to Bartlett. Phlox is going to try to clear it, but it's going to be kept in by McNally once again. Into the corner now, a battle for it, near side. Paulson in there along with Bartlett. Bartlett tried to get it out, but centers it up for Evans instead. And a good block shot by Mulligan, and a two-on-one coming back the other way, Mulligan. He passed across to Odell, just couldn't quite get it. Fluttering pass, didn't settle it down in enough time, and coming back the other way is Plamondon, but Bartlett is going to win the race of the puck. Minute 09 remaining on the power play for the Stars. 5:03 left here in the first. Being pressured hard, takes it away. Centering pass, finds Freed in front, takes the shot. Rebound was there. Good save by Carrasco Cooper as the Hogs had a nice shorthanded chance. Keeping up the pressure. As Freed is knocked off his feet. And coming back the other way, 45 seconds on the power play. Into the zone now. Gressel takes a shot and a good save by McMaster once again. Good pressure on the penalty kill from Arkansas. We'll take one more look at that shot here. Just puts it right into his belly. Holds on, no whistle. No rebound. Does get the whistle. 4:34 remaining here in the first. 38 seconds left on the power play. Face off left side of McMaster. One back to the point. Near side, Harris loads one up. Saved by McMaster. Rebound was there. But a great job by Pittman tying up his man. He's going to come out of the zone with it before losing it. Coming back the other way now. Gressel steps in. Tries to toe drag through the feet of his man. But nice play breaking that one up. into the zone once again. Nice move there by Wollington. But again, Pittman, excellent defense for the Ice Hogs. Into the zone, Sanders. 5 seconds remaining on the power play. Arkansas back to the point. Sullivan got a shot through the traffic, but didn't quite make its way to the net. And on the near side boards, coming away with it are the Stars. That's Harris. He's going to try to send it out of the zone. Pittman, once again, having a great shift. Keeps it into the zone for the Ice Hogs. Pryor and Sullivan at the blue line. But it's going to be kept in. Battle for it. And they send it all the way down the ice. 3:30 remaining. Pittman picks it up before the icing. And he's going to play it to the near side. Trying to catch the Stars in the middle of a change. Fitzgibbons finds Semmingsen up the left wing. Trying to find his way around a man, but being pushed to the ice by Wayne, and he puts Wayne back on the ice himself. A battle for it right in front of the backup goaltender. The Ice Hogs pick it up, and an errant pass as Bartlett has to retreat to his own zone. Up the near side boards, tried to find his man, but the Stars turn it back over. Fitzgibbons waits for the offside. This one just bounces back out, and the Ice Hogs are going to have to reset once again. Mulligan to Bartlett. Bartlett off the board. Semmingsen can't handle it. McNally picks it up, but it's going to be taken away by Rumancic. Rumancic steps out, high slot, takes a shot, deflected up, and out of play. Good back and forth action so far. Each team with a penalty kill. KC Stars lead 1-0. This faceoff's going to come to the right of Carrasco Cooper. It's going to be Semmingsen in there to take it. And he's going to win it back to the point. Bartlett tried to make a move, but broken up by Plamondon, and he's going to send it down the other way as Bartlett chases it down. He's got a head of steam. He's going to come up the right side, makes a move around Helsing. Tries to get it deep into the corner, leaves it for Helsing on the boards, but he has it taken away. And it's going to bounce out to center. This is Perbilski. But again, a good defensive play, and they're going to call him for a hook. Just got a little bit too aggressive in there trying to break up that play. And Arkansas is going to go down a man once again.
They're looking for that stick in on the hands right there, and he gets it locked up right between him. It was okay when he got the stick lift, but once he hooked his stick in there, they're going to get you every time for that.
And that's Semmingsen going to the box. His second penalty here in this first period. And it's Phlox in there against Wollington. Back to Hawking for the Stars. He steps in. He's forced out wide. He's going to wheel back around. Sends it to the corner. Centering pass. Once again broken up by the Ice Hawks. Trying to ice it. And they do clear the blue line, but it's slowed up for Harris, who regroups. Finds his man far side. That's Evans. Leaves it for Wollington. Wollington being pressured nicely and forced wide. Good defensive play by Wyatt Phlox, the senior. And Arkansas is going to send it down. A minute 25 on the penalty kill for the Hogs. A minute 41 remaining here in the first. Aaron Pass goes all the way down the ice, and the Hogs catch a break as the Stars get called for an icing. And Arkansas will head down to the other end with some fresh legs, looking for an offensive zone faceoff.
Well, full complement of officials out on the ice. That's pretty nice to see. They've been doing a good job in this one.
Yep. And Wollington to take the draw against, I believe that's Freed. And Wollington does win it. Harris sends it to Gressel. He's got a lot of room in front of him. And dumps it in. Off the side of Mulligan, who tries to send it out of the zone, gets another chance at it. Does send it all the way down, and Sanders and Harris are going to race to that puck. Just under a minute to play on the power play for the Stars. As we have a battle for it. Behind the Stars' net, outlet pass comes to the near side. And Bartlett picks it up for Arkansas. He's going to turn and wheel it into the zone. Freed is going to pick it up, tries to move around Harris, but Harris gets the puck to his man. I believe this is Evans. Saucer pass, nice backhand, but a good play in front by Bartlett. And they're going to blow the whistle. Nice little sauce pass. I didn't think that one was going to get down to the ground, but ultimately did, and a good backhand shot. Good play between Evans, and I believe that was Gressel and Wollington in there as well, but good defensive play. I believe that was Mulligan for the Hogs that got in there and kind of tied him up on that saucer pass. 50 seconds remaining here in the first. 33 on the penalty kill for the Hogs. Faceoff won by the Stars. Back to the point. This is Wayne. Sends one far side corner. Sanders picks it up. He's got room in front of him. Outlet pass to Freed. Is going to find his stick eventually. Tries a toe drag move. Trips up. I think he tripped himself up, but the Hogs pick it up. Back to Freed. He's got a man in front. Set in front. Saved by Carrasco Cooper. As he tried to get a stick in the way of that one and able to ultimately cover it up. Quick replay, yeah. Looks like Sanders was in front with that one. A good play by Carrasco Cooper to ultimately jump on top of it. 30 seconds remaining here in the first. 12 seconds on the penalty kill. Arkansas has been real aggressive down a man thus far. Going to dump it into the zone, but they'll let Dixon play it. Excuse me, that was Wayne. Now into the zone, making a nice move. Phlox finds his man, takes a shot, rebound. Was sitting there, but nobody home for the Ice Hogs. 5 seconds remaining here in the first period, and Mulligan content to just let the buzzer blow, and we'll head into that first intermission with the KC Stars leading this one 1-0.
A lot of back and forth action. The speed of the game, quite fast. Not quite comparable to what we see at the college level, obviously, but some pretty good plays up and down the ice by both teams. Kansas City, you like to see what they do. They like to trap Arkansas in the neutral zone and try to create offensive chances that way. Meanwhile, Northwest Arkansas is all about the forecheck. They're really trying, even on shorthanded opportunities. Sanders is in there making things happen for the Ice Hogs, but they've yet to net a goal.
Yeah, they've stayed aggressive, but you know, the goaltender, Carrasco Cooper's made a number of good saves, and I think there's been a couple rebounds that have been sitting there, but the Ice Hogs haven't quite been in position to try to capitalize on those. But, you know, for the Stars, you want to see Carrasco Cooper kind of try to clean up those rebounds a little bit. And then on the one goal down at the other end, really it was just a broken up pass in front, you know, got caught up in the Ice Hog skates, and ultimately, Plamondon found the loose puck, buried it in the back of the net, and that's where we sit right now. 1-0 Stars.
Just an incredible crowd on hand today.
Yeah, it's great to see the support for youth hockey and obviously senior night here at the Jones Center for this varsity team. So, you know, family and friends coming out to support them. And, you know, they'd love to get a win here on senior night as well. But two periods of regulation left to play to try to make that happen. They trail by a goal right now. Faceoff center ice. Second period underway. This is Sullivan. Plamondon on him. Sullivan tries to chip it out. Kept into the zone. That's Brennan fighting for it. Trying to get it out of the zone at the blue line. They do clear it out and coming the other way. And it's going to be offside. Almost called it for him. As looks like Cooper Helsing couldn't quite hold up in time. Just one too many moves right at the blue line.
Yeah,
leads to that offside.
The there, yeah.
Base off. Brennan and Phlox. Won by the Hogs. Near side, Romancic. Dumps it to the far side corner. And a battle for it there. Back out to the point. Near side, Pittman steps in, takes a shot. Rebound was there as Romancic looked to try to chip it in front as well, but a great save by William Aiden Carrasco Cooper,
yeah, Carrasco.
Or the law firm as he's known.
Carrasco Cooper has given up quite a few rebounds in this game. Northwest Arkansas has yet to capitalize on that, but look for Northwest Arkansas to start cleaning up some chances.
We'll have 11 versus 11 in the faceoff dot. Freed versus Plamondon. Won by Arkansas. Quick shot save. Carrasco Cooper ready for that one. on the far side. Now Freed picks it up, being pushed off the puck. Keeps it in the blue line, dumps it to the near side. Picks up by Sanders. Sanders in front, save. And the rebound cleared to the far side boards. Freed for Arkansas takes a body, but Sanders picks up the puck. Freed now tries to turn to get a shot. Good defensive play by Plamondon. And the outlet pass looking for Brennan as he tries to dance around a man. Can't quite do it. Mulligan picks it up for the Hogs. Outlet pass broken up. That's Wollington. Brennan had it momentarily before Sanders comes back the other way with it. He's got Mulligan and Freed. Shot! Score! And you hear this crowd erupt. One more look at this one. Sanders just steps in and buries it under the crossbar.
Now a good shot there from the namesake.
Absolutely. A couple Sanders here in the broadcast booth, and now a Sanders on the board for Arkansas as they tie this one at one. Wollington into the zone on the backhand, being forced wide. Centering pass, had a man there. Couldn't find it. Austin Evans waiting for that puck, but clearing the offsides, the Stars. Evans once again to the backhand, turn it over in front, but an excellent play by Dixon to break that one up, and now a battle for it as it does clear the blue line. It's a near side, Hawking, chipped into the zone by Wollington. And into the zone for the Ice Hogs. But the Stars are going to come away with it. Outlet pass. Finds a stick of Wollington. He's got a man in front of him and a great defensive play. Broken up. Ice Hogs look to break out. Outlet pass just ahead of the man. They call off the icing. Well, they don't call off the icing. One linesman said no, and the other one says yes. I think the yes is probably the correct call. 12:45 remaining here in the second. 1-1 game. And it's going to be Pryor in there to take the faceoff against senior Wyatt Phlox to the right side of McMaster. Loose puck ultimately won by Arkansas. This is Mulligan with it. He's going to send it near side. Romantic looks for the outlet pass, does find his man as Helsing gets it up ahead to Phlox. Phlox takes his shot and a good glove save by Carrasco Cooper. And good goaltender play on both sides of the ice here today. Each have given up a good solid goal, but have made a number of good saves, and the rebound control has been decent so far. I think both goaltenders would like to improve in that area as we get a faceoff to the right side of Carrasco Cooper, controlled by Hicks of the Stars. He'll send it to Pryor. Broken up. Centering pass by Arkansas. Broken up. Helsing leaves it for his man. Stepping in. Trying to keep their blue line. Does. Dumps it into the corner. Romantic has to chase it to the near side. He's got a man on him. That's McNally. And it's going to go to the far side corner now. Pryor. He's got a man on him. Takes a body from Helsing, but he does get the puck up ahead into the zone, but Arkansas is ultimately going to gain possession. And I believe we got a whistle. Hey, it looks like a penalty. I thought it might have been an offsides, but I think Helsing is going to head to the box for Arkansas.
It's tough for Northwest Arkansas. Well, if you would have said Arkansas or Northwest Arkansas's first goal was going to come like that, I would have said it came off of a rebound for how many I've seen Carrasco Cooper give up. But it's a snipe from Sanders as the Hogs on the board.
Freed carries it into the zone. He's got Sanders with him. Once again, Arkansas staying aggressive on the penalty kill. Centering pass. Puck was loose momentarily. Harris having some trouble with it as Sanders and Freed are giving him fits. Finally do clear the zone, and Arkansas has to back check. Carried into the zone. Evans tries a drop pass. Wollington couldn't quite get it. Trying to get the edge. Taking a body instead was Freed as Regas broke that one up. Bounding puck comes bouncing out in front. And Carrasco Cooper ready to cover that one up as Sanders was bounding towards the net. 11:24 to play, a minute 27 remaining on the penalty.
Springdale. It's been a good penalty kill all day for the Ice Hogs. It feels like they get more pressure than the Stars have been getting on their power play.
Freed versus Plamondon. Still loose. Looks like Sanders is going to come away with it. Centering pass, couldn't quite get it. And coming the other way are the Stars. Back to Paulson, takes a shot wide of the net. And Freed is trying to race it down. He lines a man up. And going to work. Good save there by McMaster. And we'll get a stoppage of play. 11 minutes to play. 103 on the power play for the Stars. Still a lot of time to work with the man advantage for KC. The Ice Hogs do get some fresh legs out there. Semmingsen, who's got a couple penalties himself so far, able to get out there on the penalty kill. He'll center this line, loses it to Plamondon. Near side, Regas takes a shot. I think it was blocked in front by Mulligan. And trying to clear the blue line. Finally does as Mulligan sends it down to Harris for the Stars. He'll send it near side, Regas. Has to settle it down off the boards. And Arkansas giving him a hard time at the blue line. Finally breaking in. Paulson, centering pass, shot misses the net wide. Good passing for the Stars, but the Hogs doing a good job on the penalty kill. 30 seconds remaining as they ice the puck. And Regas is the first one there. He's got it behind his own cage. Outlet pass, finds a man up ahead. This one's going to be chipped into the zone, but Arkansas sends it down once again. 10 seconds remaining on the penalty kill. Plamondon sends it to Paulson. He's got Semmingsen on him, though. Semmingsen trying to pick his pocket. Romancic takes it. Turnaround shot. Wheels it high of the net. And the penalty expires. Another shot. Rebound was there, but it comes bounding to the near side. And we're back to five-on-five action as this one is sent all the way down the ice. And we'll get an icing call. 9:48 to play here in the second. 1-1 game. Once again, we appreciate everyone tuning in to the Razorbacks YouTube channel for this special broadcast. This is the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs varsity team playing on senior night. Face off to the right of Carrasco Cooper. It's going to be Brennan in there to take it. And it's going to be picked up by Phlox. Centering pass. Steered aside and out of the zone. A little collision at center ice. Excuse me, at the blue line as Arkansas tries to come back the other way with it. Trying to get control of the puck, but Brennan just sends it in. He's going to chase it down. A race with Bartlett. And Bartlett's going to win it, but it's going to be picked up by Helsing. Tries to send it out to the senior, Athada. Arkansas with it. Near side boards, Fitzgibbon. Outlet pass. We do have a delayed penalty. And it's going to be on Arkansas as the Stars center one up. Shot save. And finally covered up by McMaster. But once again, Arkansas is going to go on the penalty kill. I think their fourth penalty of the game.
Yeah, Ice Hogs shooting themselves in the hoof here.
Fitzgibbons. They'll go sit down for a couple. But we mentioned it a couple times already. Northwest Arkansas staying aggressive even when they're down a man, especially with Max Sanders, who's out there currently. So we'll see if they continue that. 9:01 to play here in the second.
Head coach not looking too happy over there.
And once again on the penalty kill for Arkansas. It's going to be Freed to take the draw against Woolington. And a stoppage of play once again. I think Arkansas's head coach Mike Sullivan wants an explanation.
He's getting one.
Yeah.
Stop action for that. There are a referee now talking to the scorer's table. Once again, we'd like to thank the University of Arkansas for allowing us to use the YouTube channel for another special broadcast. Might be a double minor here. We'll see.
Yeah, I didn't see what happened behind the play. Wasn't sure who the delay was on, and it's going to be a double minor to Keegan Fitzgibbons. Nearly doubles his penalty minutes in one fell swoop as we have a battle for the puck. Freed is in there for Arkansas, and he's going to try to chip it out of the zone. Gets it to the blue line, but no farther. Finally do get it sent all the way down. 8:44 to play here in the second period. A double minor assessed to Keegan Fitzgibbons. As the Stars break out, this is Woolington up the left wing boards. He's going to be forced wide. Coming to the near side. Good patience with the puck. Back to Woolington. Now a shot towards the net. I think McMaster might have got a piece of that. Near side now. Hawking couldn't handle it. Wanted to get a quick shot, but he'll send it behind the net instead. It's going to be picked up by Sullivan, and Sullivan sends it down the ice. As Arkansas kills off the first 50 of this penalty, Woolington coming back the other way. He's got Hawking and Gressel with him, and a nice defensive play once again by Pittman, who's played excellent so far in this game. Battle for it. Pittman and Gressel. Near side Hawking sends it towards the net. Save by McMaster. Finally covers it up, or at least he tried to, and a quick whistle from the referee gets the stoppage in play. 7:51 to play. 2:50 remaining on the double minor to Fitzgibbons. Ben McMaster in net for Arkansas. 9.10 save percentage, 2.11 goals against average. And he's had to see his team kill off a number of penalties in front of him. Face off. Tied up in the skate, still loose up in the slot. Nobody want it yet. Odell goes spilling to the ice. Far side corner now. This is Brace, tries a centering pass. It's broken up and sent all the way down the ice. This one on net as Carrasco Cooper chips it to the side. 2:30 remaining in the double minor. Long pass ahead, misses the stick of everybody, and we'll get an icing call. Good break there for the Hogs.
Only halfway through this double minor. Must have been some sort of check from behind.
Be Semmingsen in there against Brennan. Picked up by Regas. Chipped out of the zone. And sent right back in by Arkansas. Romancic chasing it down. Regas. Head fake, sends it up the near side boards. Semmingsen tried to pick it up, but puck's still loose. Does get it deep momentarily before Harris picks it up for the Stars. Comes into the zone, tries a centering pass. Romancic gets a stick on it. He's going to send it all the way down once again. Good penalty kill for the Hogs. We'll see if they stay aggressive on offense as they do send one man deep, but a good play by Carrasco Cooper as the Stars break into the zone with Brace being pressured nicely. And it's going to be sent down once again. That was Helsing. And Carrasco Cooper. Good stick. Plays it near side for Pryor. And it's going to be sent out of the zone. Helsing's going to chip it back in. Delayed offside. The Hogs do clear it. And a long pass up ahead. Bartlett trying to break it up. Having trouble with it. Brace on him. Brennan there as well for the Stars. As this one is sent up and out of play. 1:17 remaining on the double minor to Fitzgibbons. 6:17 remaining here in the second.
The Stars just haven't looked dangerous at all on the power play to this point. We'll see if they can get something going off this faceoff.
And it's Woolington in there to take it against Freed. And it does come back to the point. Sanders is going to pick it up, makes a move around a man, takes a big hit. Nice check there by Hawking, carried in by Evans. Makes a move around a man, centering pass, finds Hawking, sends it across. The shot bounces through the crease, misses the net wide. KC sets up once again, centering pass. Nobody home. This one comes to the blue line, and Hawking can't keep it in. Frustratingly sends it back in, as Arkansas tries to send this one out through the center. And it's picked up by Freed. Freed makes a move around a man. It's going to be pressed wide by Wayne and into the boards. 35 remaining on the power play. Arkansas with two men deep. And a battle for the puck in the near side corner. Still fighting for it, and a delayed penalty once again. And it's going to be a tripping call.
This time on the Stars.
Yeah, wasn't sure who was going to be called on because kind of a battle on the near side boards. It's kind of hard to see that puck. I didn't see who touched it up. But ultimately, it is going to be Aaron Wayne heading to the box for 2 minutes with just 22 seconds remaining on the double minor to Keegan Fitzgibbon. So Arkansas, 22 seconds until they go on the power play. Plamondon versus Semmingson. To the right side of Carrasco, Cooper won it to Bartlett. He's on the backhand. He's just going to dump it to the corner. Romancic and McNally. McNally has it taken away by Semmingson. Trying to find the stick of Romancic, but wasn't quite ready for it. And Semmingson regains control. Pass broken up. 3 seconds till it's a 5-on-4 man advantage for Arkansas. Centering pass shot. Semmingson sends it wide of the net. 5-on-4 action. Arkansas man advantage. They got the puck behind the net. Centering pass. Errant. Plamondon picks it up. Leaves it for Gressel. Broken up. And he does find his man into the zone. That's Gressel. Has it broken up. Semmingson chipped at it. Missed it. But now carrying it ahead into the zone. Nice move. Gets it to Semmingson. Block in front by Hicks. And he can't gather in his own rebound. They'll send it out of the zone. 107 remaining on the power play for Arkansas. 4:26 in the second period. Fitzgibbons. Cross the blue line. Head up. Steps in between two men. Takes a shot. Good save by Carrasco Cooper. And now it's McNally. Before he has it taken away from him. That's near side now. Centering pass, broken up in front, and that one's going to come out of the zone. 4 minutes to play here in the second. 35 left on the power play. Arkansas looking to get it in the zone. Freed, left side, takes a shot. Rebound is there, covered up by Carrasco Cooper. And Arkansas will get an offensive zone faceoff. Go back, look at that chance here. Fitzgibbons just dances around a couple guys and then a chip shot. Good awareness by Carrasco Cooper to make that save, but a nifty play there by Fitzgibbons after taking a 4 minute rest on that double minor. 28 seconds remaining on the power play for Arkansas. 3:49 here in the second. Face off to the right side of Carrasco Cooper. It's going to be Chance Freed in there to take it against Jacob Paulson. Again, Arkansas with a man advantage. Big face-off here. Freed won it, but just looked at it. Arkansas does get it to the corner as Bartlett finds his man there. Sends it near side. They were trying to get it back to the point, but only one defenseman back on the play, and Paulson is going to carry it ahead for the Stars. Does get a shot on net. Good backhand. Steered aside nicely by McMaster. 8 seconds remaining on the penalty. And skating out of the zone is Freed. Makes a move at the blue line, gets it into the zone, leaves it for his man, Sanders. Sanders, near side, Phlox. 5-on-5 action. Phlox, back door, had a man freed, but the puck just bounced over his stick. And Phlox is going to pick it up once again near side. Steps out in front, good block. Freed with the puck for Arkansas. Centering pass, finds Sullivan, just dumps it to the corner. Phlox, centering pass, broken up nicely in front by Regis. And once again, Arkansas controls it. And the KC Stars send it the other way in a breakaway. Paulson coming the other way, takes a shot, saved by McMaster. And a good job jumping on top of that rebound as a man was crashing towards the net. Good chance there for the Stars. But a better save by the goaltender, Ben McMaster.
Yeah, McMaster's been excellent in this game so far. I know he gave up the one goal already. But he's given up a lot fewer rebounds than we've seen on the other end of the ice. He's really swallowed them up.
Good face-off win for the Stars. They'll dump it to the corner. Mulligan has Wollington and Brenning on him. This puck comes bounding out. Dixon tried to get it out of the zone, just missed it. That one looked like it came out of the zone, but Evans takes a shot off the helmet. Rebound, shot, score! They had a couple chances at that one. I think it hit McMaster in the face. And then ultimately, a couple rebounds later. Yeah, right off the helmet. And then Evans got a stick on it. And then ultimately, Wollington buries that one in the back of the net. We'll take one more look at it. Off the face mask. Wollington sitting on the doorstep. One of the easiest goals he'll get all year. And KC leads 2-1. Face off back at center ice. 2:30 to play here in the second period. 5-on-5 action. Near side board. Semmingsen sends it across ice. Helsing. Helsing tries a centering pass. Broken up nicely. And they'll send it to the near side. Semmingsen and Regas fighting. Battle for the puck back to the point. Mulligan takes a quick snapshot, misses the net wide. Comes to the far side for Bartlett. He tries to chip it in deep, but Woolington's going to pick it up. Tries to get an outlet pass. Broken up by Arkansas. 1:55 to play here in the second. Rumancic for the Hogs. Circles around. Intercepted pass by Harris. He had a head of steam, but couldn't quite get the puck to go with him. Brennan chips it into the corner. Woolington has it taken away from him nicely. Sends it near side. Romantic as Harris steps up, puts a body on him. Good defensive play. Mulligan does get it out of the zone. He's going to send it down. No icing as it's played by Carrasco Cooper. And Helsing chips one in front. Still there. Finally covered up by Carrasco Cooper. Heads up play, and Arkansas almost got a cheap one there. Take a peek at it. Puck is just loose behind the net. He just chips it in front. Good awareness by Carrasco Cooper, though, to hug that post. Minute 25 to play here in the second. Face off to the right side of Carrasco Cooper. Freed. Has it taken by Gressel. Had to beat three men. Couldn't quite do it. Coming back the other way. Two on one if they hurry. Freed with the puck. Takes a shot. Score! And just like that, Arkansas ties this game at 2. As the senior puts one on the board. Good defensive play. Yeah, Freed's just going to take it himself. And he just picks the top corner. Pops the water bottle. Just beats him glove side. One more quick peek at it. What a snipe shot from the senior, and Arkansas ties this one up. Minute 10 to play. Deep into the start zone. Wayne chips it up for Hawking. Hawking up the near side boards, trying to get it out of the zone. And they finally do, but it's going to be picked up by Pittman. Has his pass intercepted. This is Gressel. Gressel takes a shot, misses the net wide. Goes to the far side boards. Fitzgibbons takes a man into the boards. As Arkansas looks to break out, some skates getting in the way. Freed from the spot where he just scored decides to circle back instead. Good defensive play by Hawking. Nice pass up ahead as Gressel has it in his skates. Perzbilski with the nice pass, but man, we're going to get another power play, I believe, as Arkansas.
Looked like a trip.
Yeah, just a battle for the puck and takes him down.
Let's see what the call is here.
That's going to be Pittman. Well, they're still trying to figure it out. It's going to be a trip. Fitzgibbons is trying to get an explanation, but Luke Pittman heads to the box for 2 minutes. Arkansas having trouble staying out of the box, but, man, Pittman has played excellent on defense so far this game. So, you know, the Hogs are going to miss him out there, but they got 2 minutes to kill off and 27.6 to do it here in the second. Face off to the right side of McMaster as Bartlett wheels it near side, tries to get it out, but finally does. Bounces to center ice. Semmingsen trying to pressure his man. Nice pass up ahead to Gressel. Finds Wollington in front. Regroups. Tried to put it between the legs of Bartlett, but couldn't quite get it. Wollington out in front. Passes to Gressel. Gressel saved by McMaster. This one bounces out in front. And a nice pass as the buzzer blows on the second period. Good game so far through two periods of action. We are tied at two. Arkansas having a tough time staying out of the penalty box.
It looks like there is going to be an actual intermission here after two periods of action.
Yep. Arkansas heads into the second intermission, tied on the scoreboard, but still a minute 33 remaining on the penalty to Luke Pittman for the trip. So they'll have to kill off that penalty when we come back for the third period.
Now, Northwest Arkansas's got to stay out of the penalty box. It's not killing them just yet, but it seems like the Stars are getting too many opportunities. You don't want to give your opponents so many opportunities on the penalty, on the power play.
Yeah. And it's I think Arkansas staying aggressive, and when they're trying to win those loose puck battles, I think that's when they're getting those penalties, whether it's, you know, they're leaning on a guy when they're racing towards the puck, or they're digging it out of the corner. It's just got to be careful with the sticks, be careful getting tied up. And like you said, it hasn't quite come back to bite them just yet, but man, every time you go in the penalty box, you're putting your team behind the eight ball and really making your goaltender work for it. And for his part, Ben McMaster has been excellent for Arkansas. And on the other side, mention his name over and over, William Aiden Carrasco Cooper, playing excellent as well. Both goaltenders really keeping their team in this game. And like I said, we're tied at two, heading into the second intermission. They are going to clean the ice, so we'll take a break with them, and we'll be back with the call of the third period here in about 10 minutes. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the Jones Center in Springdale, Arkansas, as we get set for the third period of action between the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs and the Kansas City Stars. My name is Corry Porter. Alongside me is Rich Sanders, EJ Sanders on camera. Happy to be here once again. Big thanks to the Razorbacks hockey team for allowing us to use their YouTube channel to broadcast this special senior night game between the Ice Hogs and the Stars. We got a 2-2 game. Arkansas is going to come out in this third period with a minute 33 remaining on a penalty to Luke Pittman. And to recap our scoring so far and a couple stats, I'll throw it over to you, Rich.
Well, appreciate that. That's 2-2 after two. It's 17-17 in the shots. The faceoffs is one area where Kansas City has the edge. Had a 7-2 lead after one period, and they maintain that lead through two. The scoring, Plomondon from Paulson at 6:02 of the first period on a puck that got loose sitting in front of the net. The second period, Saunders scored at 1:18 on a tip out of the zone from Bartlett. Kansas City took the lead again at 12:29 on Woolington's goal from Evans to make it 2-1. And then at 13:49, Freed on another tip out play where the forwards are doing most of the work. But that came from Sullivan to knot it again at 2-2. The penalty minutes, it's 12-4. Northwest Arkansas with 12 of the penalty minutes to only 4 for Kansas City. But the shots on the penalty, on the power play, Northwest Arkansas has 3, and Kansas City's been limited to only 2 on the last 5 penalties. So other than their first penalty where they kind of put some pressure on Northwest Arkansas, the rest of the game, the Northwest Arkansas penalty kill has been pretty good.
Appreciate that recap, and you know, the penalties is something that really stands out to me in those first two periods for Arkansas. Hasn't come back to bite them yet. We talked about it a little bit at the end of the second period, but you know, a tie game, close game like this, you can't be getting in the penalty box, so they'll need to clean some of that up. And like we said, they got a minute 33 left to kill off of Pittman's penalty to start this third period, but you know, it's shaping up to be a good one here. In goal for the KC Stars, William Aiden Carrasco Cooper. And opposite him, number 35, Ben McMaster for the Ice Hogs. I'm sure both goaltenders will be instrumental in whoever walks away with a win in this one. And both have looked good so far. Both teams getting ready to take the ice. We do have 2 referees, 2 linesmen.
You go back and look at the goals. Northwest Arkansas's goals have both been on snipes outside that zone where it's dangerous. And both of Kansas City goals have been kind of, you know, what I'd call garbage goals that they earned, no doubt, but it's because they penetrated close into the goalkeeper arc.
And we are set for face-off at center ice. Won by the Stars, but taken by Saunders. Makes a move. Picked up by Bartlett. Fanned on the shot. Freed once again. Finally gets it through. Carrasco Cooper with a save as Saunders gathers it in. Tries to wheel it back behind him, but it's taken away. Nice pass up ahead, but Evans couldn't quite handle it. Bounces into the corner. Now Mulligan sends it down the ice. 1:08 remaining on the penalty kill. And Woolington's going to pick it up for the Stars. Saunders pressuring him. Arkansas has been real aggressive on the penalty kill. And Woolington skates through a man, plays it up ahead to Evans. Evans being forced wide once again by Mulligan. Back to Harris, back to Evans, being pressured by Bartlett. Awkward bounce off the boards, but finally gathered in. This is Gressel. Has it taken away from him by Mulligan. Freed in there as well. Being pressed up against the boards. 30 seconds remaining on the power play. Still a battle for it. Finally sent all the way down the ice by Arkansas as they continue their excellent penalty kill. Regas picks it up for the Stars as Arkansas gets a full line change. chipped into the zone by Gressel, but linesman said he missed it, and we're going to get an icing call. Another good break here for the Hogs. 14 seconds remaining on their penalty, but they're going to get an offensive zone faceoff, which is exactly where they want to be. 13:41 remaining here in the third period. Tied at two, faceoff to the left side of Carrasco Cooper, the goaltender of record for the Stars. And it's going to be Pryor in there to take it against Phlox. McNally has it for the Stars, plays it to Pryor. Outlet pass, chip to center ice. Played ahead, Odell. Cross the red line, chips it in, and Phlox is going to have to chase it. He does get there in the corner. He's going to win the puck, centers it up. It's just sitting there. Nobody there to pick it up, and a huge hit laid on. And he kept the puck in the zone. Nice play there by Mulligan. And we're going to get another penalty. And this one, a cross check. See if we can catch it in the corner here. It looked like he might have been already kind of going down, but
it's a dangerous area, though, and when you the ref is right there. I mean, if you're staring him in the numbers, he's going to call that.
Yeah.
You can't give him a reason to call those penalties, and I think the officiating's been pretty good today. I don't think that there's anything wrong with the calls that they've made.
So. Yeah, I think it was a good, clean hit at the blue line. Excellent job keeping the puck in, but just using the stick on the hit in the corner sends Fitzgibbons to the box for 2 minutes. 13-11 here in the third. And once again, a power play for the KC Stars. Pryor in there to take it against Phlox. And the Stars can't keep it in the zone. Odell trying to chase it down. And Wollington with a head of steam. He does get it out of the zone. Slowed up a bit. Paulson picks it up for the Stars. Being forced wide by Phlox. Back to the point. Hicks takes the shot. Tipped in front. Goes wide of the net. Near side corner now. Minute 35 on the power play. Sullivan for the Hogs. Plays it off the boards to himself. Pittman tried to pick it up. Gathered in by the Stars. Paulson couldn't handle the centering pass. Trying to get it out. Finally do. As a man spills to the ice. And Hicks picks it up for the Stars. Outlet pass. Pryor. He turns. Tries to turn on the Jets. Brennan picks it up. He's got Pryor. Makes a move. Brennan tried to get it across to Pryor, but an excellent defensive play by Sullivan sends it to the far side corner. And a loose stick is down on the ice. At the point now. 52 seconds remaining on the power play. Star centering pass. Kick save by McMaster and sent all the way down the ice by Rumancic as the Ice Hogs continue to kill off this penalty. Outlet pass, broken up, centered. Rumancic couldn't get a shot away. Good defensive play by Pryor on the back check. Rumancic, and we're going to get a whistle.
Rumancic checked the goaltender as well for his efforts.
Yeah, and looks like it didn't knock the net off its mooring, so we'll get a whistle for that. But nice play breaking that outlet pass up. And a centering pass from Mancic couldn't quite get the shot away as Tristan Pryor for the Stars with an excellent back check. Broke up the play, but got his goaltender bumped a little bit because of it. But Carrasco Cooper, the goaltender for the Stars, will see a faceoff to his right side and sees his centerman win it before Saunders turns and takes a shot. It goes begging. Near side now. Battle for the puck. The Stars have it. This is Evans. He's got a man in his back pocket. He's going to be forced wide. And a good play by Bartlett as Wollington tried to pick it up. And Evans takes it away from Freed. Tried to take a shot in front, but once again broken up by Mulligan. Three on one if they hurry. Mulligan across the blue line. Takes a shot. Sails high of the net. And out across the blue line. Just clearing the offsides where the Ice Hogs as Saunders picks it up. He's going to flip it up to himself into the corner. He's got a couple men down there on him, and they'll play it near side now. Looking to break out of the zone is Gressel. He'll dump it in, chase it down as the Stars get a change. 10:46 remaining here in the third period. Tied at two. Turned over. Shot in front. Rebound sitting there on the doorstep. Dangerous play as the Stars almost got one. as I think McMaster was looking the other way. Yeah, taking another quick look at it. Just a turnover behind the net. McMaster looks to the other side. Quick centering play.
That's exactly how they've been getting their goals.
And ultimately, McMaster does make the save and covers it up after the scramble in front. But
well, here we are, 3:37 of this period already. Northwest Arkansas has been in the penalty box, so if they can stay out, they've kept the game tied 2-2.
This one goes up and out of play. I think we'll get another face-off inside the zone. 10:34 remaining. Like you mentioned, Arkansas racking up the penalty minutes. Really need to clean that up here in the latter stages of this game. Plamondon take the face-off. He does win it against Semingson. Shot in front. Tip to the corner. That was Persbilski. And Helsing trying to chase it out. He does get it into the zone. No offside. Ooh. A crash into the boards. And this one does get blown dead. And they are going to call a trip on that, I think.
Yep. Another penalty to the Ice Hogs.
Yeah, this one kind of a dangerous play. We'll take a look at it. And luckily, everyone hopped right back up as you see him crashing into the corner. Little hit from behind, and happy to see him pop right back up.
2 minutes for roughing.
Yep.
That's the call.
Romancic heads to the box. Arkansas heads to the penalty kill.
Well, what was that about staying out of the box?
I take it back.
Face off, back to the point. Near side, Wayne takes a shot wide of the net. Picked up now behind the net. This is Paulson. Backhand pass finds Regis. Dumps it into the corner. Persbilski. Near side, Wayne tries to take a shot. Deflected in front. This one's going to be chipped up and out of the zone. Gathered in by the Stars. Paulson, cross-ice pass. Near side, chips it ahead. Brennan can't handle it. Helsing turns and sends it down the ice. As 30 seconds have expired on this penalty kill for Arkansas. And this pass nearly intercepted. Does keep it into the zone. Saunders sends it at the net. Freed tried to get a tip on it, but it goes wide. Freed finds Saunders. Brennan for the Stars chips it to the near side corner, and he's got a head of steam coming into the zone. Takes a bump from Saunders. Takes a bump from Pittman, and Brennan still throwing the body around, still fighting for that puck in the near side corner. This is Paulson now. Gets it back to the point. Back to Paulson, or at least he tried to, as Pittman's in there. Pittman sends it all the way down the ice with 50 seconds remaining on the penalty kill. And breaking out of the zone now are the Stars as Bartlett takes it away and sends it back in. Steered aside by Carrasco Cooper. 36 seconds remaining on the power play for the Stars, but they spent most of this back in their own zone. As this breakout is stymied by the Ice Hogs once again. That hit a weird spot on the ice and bounced to the near side boards. 20 seconds remaining on the penalty. The Stars looking for one more rush as Brace makes a move to the near side, leaves it for Harris. Wasn't quite ready for it, but he does get the puck back. Centering pass, had Brennan in front. Couldn't find the puck back to the point. Near side. Chipped in. This is Brace as the penalty expires. 5-on-5 action. Mulligan picks it up for the Ice Hogs. And he's going to send it all the way down the ice for an icing. 8:10 remaining here in the third. 2-2. This will be a face-off to the left side of the goaltender McMaster. And I think the Stars continue to fare well in the face-off dot. Face off. Won by the Stars. This is Evans. Sends it to the corner. Bartlett and Gressel. Bartlett centers it in front of his own net. A shot and a save. Puck is still loose. Dangerous play by Bartlett. As McMaster needs to get back in position. Arkansas near side boards. Bounces back out in front again. And Otell has seen enough. He said, I'm getting it out. And McNally chases it down as he sees his goaltender Carrasco Cooper cover it up. And Arkansas once again a penalty kill, but And dangerous play at the end there by Bartlett. Sent it out in front of his own net. And Wollington had a couple of swings at it, but good saves by McMaster. And ultimately, Arkansas sent it down the other way, and they'll get a faceoff in the star zone to the left side of Carrasco Cooper. Faceoff won by the Stars. They're going to send it out of the zone. Far side, it's Pittman. He's got Evans pressuring him. Sends it in front again. He has to glove it down. Arkansas needs to keep the puck out from in front of their own net. Semikson, Rumancic, just onside. Rumancic tries to send it back to Semikson, but it's going to be picked up instead by Gressel. Sends it ahead. Evans missed the puck. Pittman chasing it down for the Ice Hogs. Stopping move. Out in front of his own net again. That's three times Arkansas has done that, and three times that the Stars have gotten a stick on it. Out in front of the net again. Pittman circles back. Sends it out to Helsing. Can't clear his own zone. Finally does. Semikson near side boards. And it takes a shot. Bounces the water bottle off the net, but went off the side of the net. Back out in front. Takes another shot and another save by Carrasco Cooper. Rebound to the far side corner. Outlet pass, broken up, sent back in. Helsing racing the puck, centers it up, but a nice defensive play by Wayne in front sends it back to the corner. Battle for it once again, and it's going to be sent to the near side boards, pinching in as Sullivan takes a hit, but keeps the puck in. Comes all the way to the other side. Pittman has to keep it in on his side. Sends it down low. Romancic, centering pass, gets through everybody. Sullivan keeps it in at the blue line. Arkansas able to get a little bit of a line change, but the Stars having a hard time getting out of the zone. Turnaround shot, save once again. Rebound to the corner. This one finally chipped out, and it is going to be an icing. And the Stars will be able to get a change. 2-2 game, 5:57 remaining here in the third period. A lot of game action left, Rich.
There is. I'm just sitting here kind of trying to figure out. I guess you can change on the icing at this level.
That's a thought I was having as well, so I appreciate that in my men's league games. When we're tired, we just ice the puck and get a change.
Getting ready for men's league hockey, are they?
Absolutely.
There you go.
Sanders, far side, tried to get it in the zone. Sanders broke up the play, but the Stars ultimately regained control, and this one, I believe, came up and out of play. And we're going to get a face-off outside the zone. That's actually going to come all the way back to the Arkansas end.
I just want to see Przybylski do something here.
You just wanted to say the name, didn't you?
No, I wanted to hear you say it.
Well, Przybylski chasing the puck. And it's going to be Freed picking it up for the Ice Hogs. Tries to dance around him, man. Knocked him over. Freed picks it up once again. Takes a shot. Save. Rebound was there. Bouncing. Back out to the point, Mulligan. Sanders just has to take it out of the zone. Circles back around. Offside is cleared. Carries it back into the zone. Pass in front. Bounced over two sticks. That's Freed and Phlox had a chance at it. Phlox just wheels it towards the net, and a good save by Carrasco Cooper, and he holds on for the whistle. Good chance there for the Hogs.
Shots remain just about dead even. The better chances have been Kansas City's, but I think that also indicates the better goalie has been Arkansas's with Ben McMaster.
Pryor versus Semingson, won by the Stars. This is Harris. Has it chipped away from him by Rumancic. Comes to the near side boards now. Controlled by Pryor. Stopping move. Outlet pass to Brennan. He's got some room to skate. Carries it across the blue line. A little snapshot. Blocked in front by Sullivan, and he was going to look to make the outlet pass. Waited too long, and it's taken away by Pryor. Sullivan near side boards. Helsing tries to get it out. Broken up by Harris. Takes a shot just wide of the net. As McMaster threw a blocker at it, Arkansas still can't clear the blue line. A nice hit by Pittman, but he'll have to retreat to his own zone. 4:20 remaining here in the third, 2-2 game between the Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs and the Kansas City Stars. Outlet pass, Helsing. He's got a man on him. gets hit by Brennan, and the puck's taken away off the board. Semmingsen tried to keep it in. Pittman does throw it in. Arkansas has to clear the offside. It's going to be the Stars to pick it up. Hicks near side to Pryor. Pryor into the zone. And he'll go for a line change. Sullivan, Sanders, a little chip pass. Broken up, 3:40 to play. See if Sullivan wants to do it himself. He's got a man up the right side, tries to find him. Good job breaking it up by the Stars, and I think we get a looks like a hand pass call. 3:32 remaining here in the third. Face off just outside the Star zone. It's like Freed in there to take it against Wollington. Freed does win it. Sanders tries to get it far side to Mulligan. To Bartlett. Off the board to Freed. And Wollington gets a stick on it momentarily before Arkansas regains control. Mulligan has his pass intercepted. Evans takes a shot. Good kick save by McMaster. Another turnover by Arkansas in front. He's there. Takes a shot and it goes wide of the net. Mulligan has it taken away once again. Gressel sitting in front. Rebound. Bounced out front, but McMaster, another good save. And Johnny on the spot. Arkansas's defense clears it out. This is Freed. Center to Phlox. Broken up nicely in front. Sent to the far side boards now. Saunders chasing it down. Evans sends it near side. Wollington chasing it down. Has a man on him. That's Bartlett. And he does get it to the blue line and ultimately out of the zone. And into the zone. Bartlett tries to take a shot. That one goes just wide of the net. Awkward bounce back to the point. Saunders, he's got room in front. Pass, one-timer, good save. Good puck movement from Arkansas. But ultimately put it right into the belly of Carrasco Cooper. Nice passing, good unselfish play by Saunders and a good one-timer.
Well, they played more than 40 minutes of hockey, and you can see the legs getting a little weary now. Things get a little bit more crazy.
And speaking of crazy, once again, Arkansas heading to the box.
In the box.
That's going to be Phlox. I didn't see what the call was. Interference. Wyatt Phlox. Only 6 penalty minutes coming into the game. So he'll add to that total, but Arkansas really having a hard time staying out of the penalty box. But we've said it all game, and, you know, I'll say it again. Arkansas has stayed aggressive on the penalty kill. They do have 5 guys out there and no penalty up on the board, so I don't know if this is a we do have 5-on-5 action. And the faceoff in the Arkansas zone is won by the Stars. They send it deep into the corner. Pittman's going to send it far side. Rumancic has Hawking in front of him. They collide. Both men go spilling to the ice. Still a battle for the puck as it's caught underneath them. But the Stars hold the blue line. Loose stick. Finally get it down low. Paulson wasn't quite ready for it as Sullivan sends it near side. Helsing puts it off the boards, looking for Semmingsen. Minute 50 to play, and they blow it dead for an icing. Minute 51 to be exact. And this one comes all the way back to the Arkansas end. It's going to be Freed versus Pryor in the faceoff dot. Centering pass, broken up. This is Freed coming back the other way, 2-on-1. Got a man behind him as well. Freed takes a shot, good block in front. Picked up, shot just wide of the net. Fitzgibbons coming back the other way of the Stars. Carrying it out of the zone. This is Brace, tried to get in the offensive zone, but just offside. And we got a minute 31 to play. Arkansas with a good chance down at the other end. Good defensive play, however. Face off. Still loose. Finally sent into the zone by Brace. And Pryor wins the race to the puck. Bartlett spills to the ice but steals the puck away. Off the boards, Freed was looking for a little give and go, but Fitzgibbons takes his time with it, loses it, regains control, sends it up ahead to Freed. But it's taken away by the Stars. Trying to break out of their own zone. A minute to play. Mulligan plays it ahead to Fitzgibbons. Good play. Breaking that up by Regas. And once again, Ice Hogs regroup. They send it far side into the zone. This one's going to be waved off. The icing will be. And Arkansas has a man in front. Fitzgibbons in front. Shot. Score! With 40 seconds remaining, Arkansas takes a 3-2 lead.
It's Freed again. Chance Freed.
Yeah, and this all starts with Fitzgibbons. Really with Saunders pressuring the play. And then ultimately Fitzgibbons picking it up in the corner. Good turnover and a nice backhanded play by Freed to put Arkansas on top.
Timeout here for Kansas City. Wow, what a turn of events. Kind of seemed like we were in a lull of the action there for a bit.
Yeah, I was about to Google the high school rules for they go in overtime, they go in shootout. What are we doing here? But
may not need it.
Need it as Arkansas. Excellent play in the offensive zone. I'm going to go ahead and take one more look at it because it starts with Saunders right here. Just putting the pressure on him. Makes him lose it, and then Fitzgibbons picks it up. Freed goes to the net, just textbook triangle play and a nice little play. And man, that's tough for Carrasco Cooper as he was in position to make that first save, but the nice little deke move by Freed to pull it to the backhand, able to just squeak it under that left pad of Carrasco Cooper, who has looked excellent today. And Arkansas 40.4 seconds on the clock to try to escape this one with a late win. Face off back out to center ice. It's going to be Freed against Wollington. Evans, near side Harris, trying to get it deep, has it poked away by Fitzgibbons. They're looking to pull the goaltender, but unable to get it deep. As Freed takes it away, he's going to try to send it into the zone. Having trouble with it. And taken away once again. This is Harris. He's going to send it down. We'll keep an eye on the KC net for you as we got 15 seconds left and the Stars just unable to get it deep into the zone. Arkansas playing excellent at neutral ice. Pass Fitzgibbons. Saunders. Score! With 7 seconds left, Arkansas adds the insurance goal and they're going to come away with this one with a 4-2 victory. Fitzgibbons once again just finds Saunders far side. Just those loose puck battles. And we've already seen Saunders' shot today. And he shows us again he's got a good one. 7.3 remaining. Arkansas leads this one 4-2. Face-off at center ice. One final face-off win for the Hogs. And the final buzzer. And that's how you send them off on senior night. Excellent crowd on hand here, celebrating their team, celebrating their seniors. What an excellent, gutsy win by the Hogs. Went down 1-0. Tied it up, went down 2-1, tied it up, and fought hard at the end with 40 seconds left. Got the game-winning goal and just added on the insurance goal with 7 seconds remaining. And that's where we sit, our final score, Northwest Arkansas Ice Hogs 4, Kansas City Stars 2.
Al Freed with a couple of goals in this game, and he's got to be the player of the game for the Ice Hogs.
Yeah, I think so. One other person I want to call out, for Arkansas, Luke Pittman, just an excellent defensive performance. Had the one penalty, but, man, he was breaking up everything. Every time I called his name, it was for breaking something up, coming the other way. So excellent job by Pittman as well. Yeah. You got a star, Rich.
Got to throw in Max Saunders. Two goals, two nice shots, and overall played an outstanding game, and might as well throw in McGibbony there for what he did at the end of the game. Or Fitzgibbons.
I struggled with his name all game.
I did the one time I said it.
Yep.
Great job by Northwest Arkansas today.
As they gather at center ice, I'm sure they'll do some pictures there. But we'll go ahead and sign off here. Appreciate once again the Razorback hockey team for allowing us to use the channel to broadcast the seniors, the varsity team here today. They gave us an excellent game. Hope some Razorback college fans are watching the high school team and, you know, got to enjoy that. But good gutsy win here for the Razorbacks, or excuse me, the Ice Hogs. And it was glad we were able to come out and watch this game. EJ.
Yeah, it was an excellent game. I mean, from top to bottom, I mean, there were some long lulls in the action, it felt like, but you know, in the end, the Ice Hogs were able to generate enough chances. Even though they put themselves behind the eight ball a lot, it did feel like in this game, I mean, obviously going to the penalty box 7-8 times in a game isn't something you want to see, especially in a 45-minute contest. I mean, you're looking at a third of the time in the box. But luckily for them, KC wasn't able to really capitalize on any of those chances. KC got a couple of them of goals themselves, but in the end, you know, comes down to your stars, and Freed did a great job. Saunders does a good job of adding an insurance marker with 7 seconds to go, and the Ice Hogs walk out victors.
Well, you mentioned those things that they didn't do right. They got beat in the faceoffs. They spent too much time in the penalty box. There were too many loose pucks in front of the goal, but at the end, everybody pulled together. Great goaltending there by McMaster. He wasn't going to stop those two shots. He stopped probably two or three more that could have gone in by getting on top of the puck.
All right. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in. That does it for us here. We do have the JV game coming up right after this, but the varsity team wins this one 4-2 for the team here. EJ Sanders, Rich Sanders, my name is Corey. We'll see you at the next one.